Welcome to our physics classroom, and good day everyone. Since we discussed about the electric field on our past lesson, let us now determine the importance or know what we can do with this and understand the importance of this electric field in the aspect of the electricity as we deal with our today's lesson, which is electric potential. So, electric potential is the amount of work needed to move a unit charge from a reference point to specific points against an electric field. For you to understand this definition, we will give an example. But before that, I want you to take note the word work. So, when we are referring to electric potential, we are also referring to the amount of work that is needed para ma-move natin yung charge against the direction ng ating electric field. So, tandaan, electric potential is the amount of work needed para ma-move natin yung ating charge in the direction against the direction of the electric field. No, okay, so you have to take note of that as we go on our discussion. When we are dealing with electric potential, you have to understand this electric potential energy. This is different from electric potential. When we say electric potential energy, this is the energy to a charge due to its location in an electric field. So, when we are talking electric potential energy, you have to take note that that is the amount of the energy on the charge with respect to the location ng ating charge in an electric field. Later on, we will give example for you to understand it more. One of the reasons why I give you the definition of potential energy is that because a movement of a positive test charge within the electric field is accompanied by changes in potential energy. So, potential energy has something to do with the movement of the charge. Ang sabi dito, kapag minumove daw natin yung ating positive test charge within the electric field, nagbabago yung kanyang potential energy. So, you have to take note on that. As we move the test charge, the positive test charge in the electric field, may pagbabago sa kanyang potential energy. Later on, we will give this example for you to understand it more. So, let us have an illustration. Let's say I put here a positive charge in this part. And then, sa lower part naman, meron tayong negative charges. So, if we will illustrate the electric field, this would be look like this. We know that the direction of the electric field on the positive charge ay away, but towards the negative charge. So, based on our previous discussion, I told you that the direction of the electric field would depends on the movement of the positive test charge. So, pag naglagay tayo ng positive test charge dito, magmove siya pa ganun, but papunta naman siya sa negative according to the law of charges, di ba? So, dito, ang direction ng ating electric field is in this direction. Para mas maintindihan natin, ang sabi ko kanina, as we move charge daw, there is a changes in the potential energy. So, i-label lang natin this part as higher potential energy and this part is lower potential energy. Let's say I have here a positive test charge. So, as I move this positive test charge in this direction, same with the direction of the electric field, nagbabago ang kanyang potential energy and that is decreasing. So, dito mataas pa ang kanyang potential energy. So, kapag binumove yung charge, papunta dito sa negative charge, bumababa ang kanyang potential energy. Contrary naman, yung ating positive test charge, let's say nandito siya, pupunta tayo ngayon papunta dito, which is against the direction of the electric field. So, mapapansin natin na ang kanyang potential energy is increasing. So, in that way, nagbabago ang kanyang potential energy. Later on, we will give more explanation regarding this para mas maintindihan mo how the potential energy changes as we move the charge within the electric field. Let us use the gravitational analogy or let us revisit your knowledge regarding gravitational analogy for you to understand more how the potential energy changes as we move the charge along the electric field. Let's say I have here a certain charge. A certain charge has its electric field. The reason why kapag naglagay ako ng positive test charge dito, magmo-move siya towards this negative charge because of the electric field. So kahit saan ko ilagay yung charge, it will experience the electric field. Same way on our Earth. Our Earth has its gravitational field, and all of the objects that is falling towards the Earth experience this gravitational field. Even you, when you jump from a certain height, you'd be able to experience this gravitational field. And it is also similar with the experience ng ating charge as it's go along with the gravitational, electric field of this charge. So the reason why the electric field, the reason why the object has its work or nagbo-move siya and also the acceleration within the Earth is because of the field. Now, when we say acceleration, that is the change in velocity. So later on, you'd be able to understand why I use this analogy. Basta, gusto ko lang ipakita dito sa illustration na to na yung ating charge and yung Earth, yung nararamdaman ng isang object when it moves towards the Earth is same way with the experience ng ating charge when it is around the electric field of a certain charge. We know that an object can have gravitational potential energy. Moving an object upward against the gravitational field increases its gravitational potential energy. So in this case, ang gravity natin or the gravitational field is in this direction. And yet, imumove natin yung object upward. And the direction of the movement of the object is against the direction of the gravity. Kapag kaganyan, ang object natin, ang kanyang gravitational potential energy increases. No, sa higher position, mas mataas ang kanyang potential energy pagdating dito than sa position na kung saan nandun siya sa surface ng Earth. So as we move the object, the gravitational potential energy of the object increases because we are moving against the direction of the gravity or gravitational field. Contrary, an object moving downward within the gravitational field would lose gravitational potential energy. Kanina, as we move the object upward or against the direction of the gravitational field, the potential energy increases. In this case, we are moving same with the direction of gravitational field. Or in this case, the gravitational potential energy of the object is losing or decreasing. So, pagdating dito naman sa position dito, on above the surface of the Earth, meron siyang mababang gravitational potential energy. Sa taas, mataas ang kanyang gravitational potential energy. And it is losing kapag ang object is moving downward. Pag upward naman, the gravitational potential energy is increasing. It was reasoned that movement of a positive test charge within the electric field is accompanied by changes in potential energy. I already introduced you a while ago that whenever we move a charge towards this electric field, there is a changes in the potential energy of the charge. Also, moving a positive test charge against the direction of the electric field is like moving a mass upward within Earth's gravitational field. So, kaya natin ni-review kanina yung gravitational potential energy because it is similar to the concept of moving a charge and changing its potential energy. So, pagka nag-move tayo ng positive test charge against the direction of this electric field, para rin tayong nagmo-move ng object against the gravitational field, which is pagka minumove natin yung object upward. Both movement would be like going against nature and would require work by an external force. This work would in turns increase the potential energy of the object. So let's say in this example, I have here the positive charge and I have here negative charge. If we want to illustrate the electric field, this would be the illustration. As you can see, the direction of the electric field is outward the positive test charge, but towards the negative charge. In this case, let's say meron akong positive test charge in this position. And then I want to move this charge from this position to this position or this point. So, moving this positive discharge in this direction or in this position would require us a lot of work, and we need to exert effort. No, this charge will exert an effort in order for us to move this charge into this position. So in that case, kailangan meron tayong i-apply na force, and if we apply amount of force to move the charge against the direction of the electric field, dahil ang direction ng electric field ay paganto, pababa, so i-move natin ang object upward para rin kagaya siya nung nag-move tayo ng object upward the direction of the gravitational field. So, in that case, there is work done. So, remember, if we are moving the charge against the direction of the electric field, we need to exert force. And exerting a force to a certain distance, we know ang formula ng work natin is force multiplied by the distance. So, in that case, there is work done on the charge. On the other hand, the movement of a positive discharge in the direction of the electric field would be like mass falling downward within the Earth's gravitational field. So, in this case naman kanina, we are going against the direction of the electric field. So, in this example, we will illustrate the movement of a positive discharge with the direction of the electric field. So, ang sabi dito, it's like moving a mass downward within the Earth's gravitational field. Both movement would be like going with the nature and would occur without the need of work by an external force. So, for you to understand this concept, let us use this simple illustration. So, again, I have here positive charges in this upper part, and in this lower part, we have negative charges. And as you can see, we have here the electric field. So the electric field shows that the direction is going down because we have negative here and we have positive in this case. So let's say I put a positive discharge in this case, and we want to move this positive discharge to this point. As you can see, the direction of the electric field is downward, and we want to move the object or the charge rather downward. And the movement of the charge and the direction of the electric field is same. So it's like going down, it's like a mass falling down the earth lang daw. So in that case, we don't need to exert force. And force is not needed because it will occur naturally. The positive discharge will move in this direction, and naturally because of the negative charges here. Because according to the law of charges, opposite attract. So, hihilahin niya ng negative charges here, yung ating positive discharge. So, patuloy lang siyang bababa without the occurrence of the force. Unlike kanina kasi we are going against the direction of the electric field. So, we need to exert force, and since we exert force and at a certain force, merong distance, so may work done. So, in this case, we don't need to exert force, so there is no work done in this charge because it will course naturally. So we can infer that if the charge is going with the direction of the electric field, there is no work done on the charge. For you to understand it more, let us have an example. Let's say I have here a positive charge, and that positive charge has its electric field, and the direction of the electric field would be like this, in this direction. Let's say I have here position A and I have position B. So let's say dito sa position A, I put the positive charge. And then we have position B. I want to move this positive charge or test charge from point A to point B. So in that case, the direction of the charge would be in this direction, from point A to point B. Given that the direction of the electric field is in this direction, and we want to move the charge against the direction of the electric field, so we need to exert force. And when we exert force towards this positive discharge to move this charge to this position, there is also a change in the distance. Force and distance would mean that we apply work Or meaning there is a work done on the charge. Because sabi ko nga kanina, if we want to move or if the charge is moving against the direction of the electric field, there is work done. And at the same time, the potential energy of the object is increasing in this case. So, para i-clarify yan, lagyan lang natin ng more precise na explanation. Moving the positive test charge from the location A to location B will require work. And at the same time, if there is a work done, the potential energy is increasing. Or from point A hanggang sa makarating siya sa point B, mataas ang potential energy ng ating charge in that case. Another example, I have here a positive charge. And here is the direction of the electric field. Again, I have here point A and point B. In that case, ilalagay natin si positive test charge at point B. If we want to move the positive test charge from point B to point A, so the direction of the movement of the charge would be in this case. So this would be like that. So as you can see, the direction of the electric field and the movement of the charge is same, no? Going right. So in that case, it will occur naturally. So there is no work done because we don't need to exert force. And at the same time, the test charge will move naturally on the direction of the electric field. Lagi niyong tatandaan na kapag ang direction ng electric field and direction of movement of the charge is same, imu-move natin siya from point B to A, there is no work done because it will occur naturally. And at the same time, no, the potential energy decreases. Dito, potential energy increases, potential energy decreases. There is work done, there is no work done. Now, let us know whether you understand the definition or the explanation that I gave you a while ago. Let us have an activity. Okay, here is the instruction. The following diagram show an electric field represented by arrows and two points, labeled A and B. So, meron tayong two points again, labeled A and B, located within the electric field. A positive test charge is shown at a point A. So, in that case, ang ilalagay, ang nandito sa problem, ang positive test charge daw ay nasa point A. For each diagram, indicate whether work must be done upon the charge to move it from point A to point B. So, we will move the charge from point A to point B. So, we're going to determine if there is work done or none. Finally, indicate the point A or B with the greatest electric potential energy and greatest electric potential. So, indicate natin kung saan mas mataas ang potential energy, sa point A or sa point B. So, let's start. Let's say I have here the direction of the electric field. So, in that case, the direction of the electric field is moving upward. And then, we have two points. No? So, this one is a point A and this one is point B. Sabi sa problem, ang ating test charge would be on the position of point A. So, nasa point A ang ating test charge. Ang direction ng electric field natin ay ganyan. And then, we want to move, and then, ang movement daw ng charge natin would be from point A to point B. So, imu-move natin yung charge from point A to point B. And this is the direction of the electric field. The question is there a work done? Is there a work done on charge? Yes or no? Second one, electric P is greatest at point A or point B. So, saan dyan mas mataas ang potential energy based on the discussion kanina? Next, electric potential is greatest at point A or point B. So, now let us analyze for us to be able to answer. Sabi ko kanina, if we are going against the direction of the electric field, there is work done. So, in this case, ang direction ng ating electric field is in this direction. And the direction of our movement of our charge is from point A to point B. And it is going downward. As you can see, it is obvious that the movement of the charge and the direction of the electric field is different or different direction. So, in that case, there is a work done. Because the charge is moving against the nature and work is required to move it against the electric field. Next, electric potential or potential energy is greatest at point B. Bakit point B? Sabi ko sa inyo, if the direction of the movement of the charge is against the direction of the electric field, the potential energy is increasing. So, in this case, so increasing siya. So, pag na-reach niya yung point B, mataas na siya dito. So, increasing kasi siya. So, dito mababa pa, taas. So, the answer is point B. This is the reason. When work is done to move an object against nature, the potential energy of the object is increasing. In this case, the charge. So, also, electric potential energy and electric potential is directly proportional. So, kung saan din mataas ang potential energy, doon din mataas ang electric potential. And another, no, the electric potential is greater at location of a higher potential energy. So, kung saan mataas ang potential energy, doon din mataas ang electric potential. So, I hope you understand this example. Okay, let us have another activity. Same instruction pa rin, no? So, let's say I have here the direction of the electric field upward. Again, we have position A and position B. So, sabi dyan, ang test charge natin would be at location A. And then, the movement of the charge is from point A to point B. So, the question would be, is work done on charge? Yes or no? Electric P is greatest at point A or point B. And electric potential is greatest at point A or point B. So, to answer this one, we have to determine the direction of the electric field. The direction of the electric field is upward. And at the same time, the movement of the charge from point A to point B is also upward. As you can see, the direction of the electric field and the direction of the movement of the charge is similar. So, in this case, there is no work done. Why? Because the charge is moving with the nature and work is not required when it moves with the electric field. So, lagi yung tatandaan, when the electric field or the direction of the electric field is similar with the direction of the charge, so there is no force needed for us to move the charge because it will occur naturally. And by that, if there's no force needed, so there is no work done on the charge. And at the same time, if the direction of the electric field and the movement of the charge is similar, so the potential energy would be decreasing. So at this point, saan mataas ang potential energy? Dito sa point A. So habang nagmo-move siya along the direction of the electric field, it is decreasing the potential energy. So, dito sa point A, mataas. Kanina, contrary. Kasi, ang potential energy natin, mataas siya at point B. Kanina. Kasi, ang direction ng ating charge or movement ng ating charge is against the direction of electric field. And at the same time, yung sagot natin kanina, there is a work done because against yon. In this case, pareho. So, there is no work done. And here's the explanation. The charge moves naturally in the direction of the electric field. So, lagi niyong tatandaan, if the charge is moving in the direction of the electric field, the potential energy decreases. Pag against, increases. Kapag same movement or same direction, decreases. So, kung anong sagot natin dito ay A, ang sagot din natin dito would be A, because electric potential and potential energy are directly proportional to one another. And at the same time, kung saan mas mataas ang potential energy, doon din mataas ang electric potential. Or doon din mas mataas ang electric potential ng ating charge. So, magkaiba lang sila kasi kanina, ang movement ng charge natin is downward. And that is against. In this case, we have the same direction of the charge. Now, let us proceed with the equation. The symbol for electric potential can be B. Let's say I have here a charge And then we want to know the electric potential of discharge towards this point. So meron ako ditong point. Let's say this one is point A. So I want to know the amount of the electric potential kapag ka naglagay ako dito ng test charge. So in that case, meron akong certain distance and that is R. So we want to know the value of V. So what would be the formula that we're going to use? The electric potential at any point around a point charge is given by V is equal to KQ over R squared. So as you can see in the problem, the distance around the charge and the point and around the charge and the electric potential are inversely proportional. So ibig sabihin, as the distance decreases, so mas lumalapit tayo doon sa charge, the electric potential increases. The more naman lumalayo tayo doon sa charge, the electric potential decreases. But the amount of charge is directly proportional dun sa kanyang electric potential. As you can see, so kapag malaki ang value ng ating charge, so the electric potential is larger din. So let's put legend for this. Again, V is the electric potential, Q is the amount of charge, R is the distance, and K is the Coulomb constant, and the value of that K is 9.0 times 10 raised to 9 Newton square meter per Coulomb square. Another formula for us to use for electric potential would be V is equal to U over Q. U here is the potential energy, and the unit for potential energy is in joule, and the unit for charge is coulomb. So the unit of the electric potential would be joule per coulomb. Another formula, if the work is given, so we can use work over charge. We know that electric potential is the amount of work needed to move the charge against the direction of the electric field. And the unit for work is joule, and the unit for charge is coulomb, so that would be joule per coulomb din, pareho lang. So kahit alin dito pwede natin gamitin. If the potential energy is given, so ulitin ko, U is potential energy, we will use this formula. If work is given, we will use this formula. Again, the legend would be electric potential, Q is the amount of the point charge that is in coulomb, W is the work done on charge, and U is the potential energy needed to move the charge. Now, let us proceed with calculation. Before we solve problems, I want you to ready yourself by preparing the following material. So, you have to make sure that you have your calculator with you. You have your paper, your pen, your scratch that you're going to use in this solving problem. Again, we will use this RESA format, given, required, equation, solution, and the answer. Okay, let us have problem. Calculate the amount of the electric potential at a certain point 15 centimeter away from the charge of 2 microcoulomb. So, if you want to solve the problem, given that I already show you the equation that we're going to use in this electric potential lesson, so you may solve this problem by pausing the video for a while and then play it when you have the answer with you. So, let's start. Let us illustrate the problem first. So, this is the charge. So, the distance between the charge and the point at a certain point is 15 centimeter. Let's say maglalagay daw tayo 15 centimeter away from this charge. And ang value ng ating charge is 2 microcoulomb. So, we need to find the value of the electric potential. So, let's start with the given. From the problem, we have 15 centimeter and that is the value of our R. 15 centimeter, I converted it into meter kasi kailangan natin ng meter. And then we have 2 microcoulomb and that is the value of our charge. So I already put it into its base form, which is 2.0 times 10 negative 6. Ang ibig sabihin ng micro is negative 6 times 10 negative 6 coulomb. And then the value of our Coulomb constant, nilagay na natin para din makalimutan, which is 9.0 times 10 raised to 9 Newton square meter per Coulomb square or square Coulomb. And then the required Obviously, from the problem, we need to find the electric potential, and that is V question mark. So the equation for this would be is equal to K Q over R. So from the given, malalaman mo na kung ano equation ang gagamitin mo. So the solution, substitute lang natin tong given sa ating equation. So the solution would be value of RK is 9.0 times 10 raised to 9 Newton square meter per coulomb square or square coulomb over the value of the charge which is 2.0 times 10 raised to negative 6 coulomb or that is the micro coulomb divided by 0.15 meter. So the answer would be in this case, so answer na lang natin yung mga unit. So yung meter, coulomb, and another coulomb here, makakancel din natin. So yan. The answer would be 1.20 times 10 raised to 5 Newton meter per coulomb. So Newton meter na lang natirang unit. Or pwede rin natin express na for 1.20 times 10 raised to 5 joule per coulomb. Kasi ang Newton meter is also equivalent to joule per coulomb. Or pwede rin volt. So, kahit alin ditong unit na to would be correct, no? So, it can be Newton meter per coulomb or joule per coulomb or volts. I hope you have the same answer with me if you try to solve this problem. Okay, let us have another problem. An electron is raised through a potential difference of 3,000 volts. What is the work done on the electron? So, if you want to try to solve the problem, you may try to solve it and then play if you have the answer with you. So, let's start. Let's find the given. So, from the problem, we have electron. So, one electron is equivalent to 1.6 times 10 raised to negative 19 coulomb. So, I already shown you the value of an electron. So, how many coulombs do we have in an electron? The answer is 1.6 times 10 raised to negative 19 coulomb. So, kahit wala siya dyan sa problem, I already give you the this value. So, gagamitin natin siya. Another one is 3,000 volts and that is the amount of voltage. So, let's put it on the given. Another is the required. So, from the problem, ang tinatanong dyan is work done on the electron. So, we need to find the value of work. So, the equation to be used since we have the formula, we have the given QB and the needed is W or work. So, the formula would be V is equal to work per charge. So this is another formula that we're going to use when we are calculating electric potential. So in this case, work ang hinahanap, so we need to derive this equation. So when we derive this equation, this would become work is equal to product of electric potential and the amount of charge. Now we have the equation, so just substitute the given to the equation. So let us proceed with the solution. So, V is equal to value of our voltage, which is 3,000 volts, and the value of our charge, which is 1.6 times 10 raised to negative 19 coulomb. So, multiplying them together, and then, so, cancel muna natin yung mga units na makakancel, and then the answer would be 4.8 times 10 negative 16 Newton meter. Or pwede naman, we convert this Newton meter into joule since the unit of work is in energy. And so the answer would be 4.8 times 10 negative 6 joule. So either of this unit would be correct. Now let us proceed with electric potential difference. When we say electric potential difference, it is the difference in the electric potential between the final and the initial position when work is done upon charge to change its potential energy. So, from the word difference, we are calculating the difference of the electric potential from the final and the initial position. So, the equation would be delta V. So, since we're getting the difference, so that would be delta voltage is equal to the final minus initial voltage. So, napakadali lang ng equation. All we need to do is to calculate the value of the V kung hindi siya binigay sa problem and then the value of the initial electric potential, then in minus sila from final to initial, then we could be able to calculate the electric potential difference. For us to be able to apply the equation that I've shown you a while ago regarding electric potential difference, let us have an example. Let's say I have here a positive charge and the value of this charge is 1.6 times 10 raised to negative 19 coulomb. And then we have point A, and ang distance ni point A to the charge is 2.5 times 10 raised to negative 11 meter. And then we have point B, and the value of this point B is 4.2, yung layo niya mula dito is 4.2 times 10 raised to negative 12 meter. So as you can see, sa example natin, mas malayo ang point B kaysa sa point A dito sa ating charge, no? Kaya mas malaki ang value nito in meter. So this is the distance. So we are referring to the distance. In this case, we want to find the value of the electric potential difference from point A to point B. So, mula dito, papunta dito, if dito daw yung naglalagay daw tayo ng charge, from point A papunta sa point B, what would be the electric potential difference? Another, ang ikakalculate natin is the electric potential from point B naman to point A. So, vice versa. So, ito from point A to point B, ito naman from point B to point A. For us to be able to calculate that, we need to find the value of the electric potential at point A and the electric potential at point B. So now let us start solving the electric potential at point A. So the formula would be BA is equal to Coulomb constant over charge and the distance from point A to the charge. So, substitute natin, Coulomb constant, 9.0 times 10 raised to 9, and the value of the charge is this one, and this one is the value of the distance of the point A to the charge. So, we're referring to the distance nito, and that is given 2.5 times 10 raised to negative 11. Solving this will give us the value of electric potential for A is equal to 57.6 voltage. Another, let us solve the electric potential at point B. So the formula would be electric potential at point B will be equal to K over Q over R. And the value of K is 9.0 times 10 raised to 9 and the value of R charge. And the distance from point B to the charge is 4.2 times 10 raised to negative 11. So the answer would be B is equal to 34.2 volts. So that is the electric potential for point A, and this is the electric potential for point B. Since we are done calculating the value of the electric potential at point A, which is 57.6 volts, and the electric potential or point B is also calculated, and that is 34.2 volts. We can now calculate the electric potential from point A to B and also the electric potential difference from point B to A. So let's write again the equation. Electric potential is equal to final minus initial. So ang question natin kanina is electric potential from point A to B. So this would be from point A to B. Ano kaya ang magiging value ng ating electric potential difference? So electric potential difference, lagay natin dito subscript from point A to B. That would be final minus initial. Ang final position is B. So that would be B, electric potential of B, minus electric potential of A. So again, that this is the final position and this is initial. So yun ang formula. Kasi ang hahanapin natin is the electric potential from point A ka mag-start papunta sa position B or point B. So, ano kaya ang magiging electric potential difference? So, substitute lang natin since meron na tayong value ng electric potential ng B and that is 34.2. And then, we have the electric potential at point B na solved na natin kanina and that is 57.6. So, substitute lang natin electric potential delta from point A to point B is equal to 34.2, the value of the final, which is BV, B sub B, and 87.6, which is the value of B sub A. Calculating this, the value of the electric potential at point A to point B would be -23.4 volts. So as you can see, ang nakuha nating value is -23. It indicates that the potential energy is decreasing. So bakit siya decreasing? 'Di ba ang electric field nito is pa ganun din. So when the direction of the electric field and the movement of the charge are the same, it will occurs naturally. Therefore, the electric potential or the and as well as the potential energy is decreasing. Kaya ang nakuha nating electric potential dito would be negative, indicating na bababa o ang kanyang electric potential. So that is decreasing. Now let us solve the electric potential difference from point B to point A. So again, this is negative indicates that the value of the electric potential is decreasing or decreases. Now let us calculate the electric potential from point B to point A naman. So ito na ang ating initial position, ito naman ang ating final position. So in this case, ang direction ng electric field natin is pa ganun, so against the direction of the electric field na. So kung meron daw akong positive test charge dito sa point B, imumove ko siya dito sa point A. What would be the electric potential difference in this case? So solve natin, electric potential difference of the position A or point B to point A is equal to final, and in final position natin would be point A in this case, and ang initial position natin would be point B. So wag malilito kapag kayo ay nagsolve. So ang kinukuha natin dito is the electric potential from point B to point A. So in this case, this would be the final, yung ating point A, and in this case, this would be the initial position, si point B. So in that, so let us substitute the value of the electric potential na na-solve natin kanina for point A is 57.6 volts and the value of the electric potential at point B is 34.2. So solving this together will give us a value of positive 23.4. So as you can see, pareho lang ang value nila. Ang pinagkaiba lang is the sign. Kasi as you can see, ang direction ng electric field natin from point B to point A is against the direction of the electric field. The direction of the charge rather is against the direction of the electric field. So in that case, no, ang ating potential energy and also the electric potential is increasing. So pag positive ang na-solve natin, that means that the electric potential increases as we move from point B to point A. But if we move from point A to point B, the electric potential decreases. I hope you understand this one. So I'll give you example doon sa ating learning activity sheets regarding this one. So that is the end of our problem. So if you have question, just message me in my Facebook account or in our Google Classroom or in our SEPTO LMS for questions. Thank you, everyone. I hope you enjoy our discussion today. For the learning activities, you may check your Google Classroom or our Google Classroom to see the uploaded learning activities. Please submit on time.